Hello learners, I am Dr. Nilima Chopra and I welcome you to today's session on planning of curricular and co-curricular activities part 1. Well, we know that most of the activities in the school or the classrooms can be broadly classified into curricular activities or co-curricular activities. The curricular activities or the scholastic activities, as they are often called, involve teaching of subjects of various studies like languages, mathematics, science, and social sciences. For these activities, there is a conduction of exams. There are tests which are held at different points of time in the year or of the session. The learners are often evaluated on their performances. And there is a formal preparation of a progress card for the students. These activities are also strictly conducted as per the prescribed curriculum. And most often these activities are compulsory for all the students of the class. A formal timetable is often made so that these activities are conducted and prescribed according to this formal timetable. And most of the activities are conducted are confined to the classroom lessons. However, there are many other activities which are conducted in the school and the classroom. These are referred to as the co-curricular activities. And these include games, sports, music, dance, drama. They might also include other activities like gardening, participating in debates, going for excursions, and attending certain exhibitions. Most of these activities are not compulsory for all the students. And they have this choice of participating in different activities as per their ability and interests. Most often these activities, the co-curricular activities, are organized outside the classroom lessons and they do not follow a formal or a rigid timetable. These activities are also examined in a different way and not like the other academic subjects. All these activities put together are called co-curricular activities in the school. Now, both co-curricular as well as curricular activities are important. But for some people, curricular activities is given more emphasis and they are considered as primary activities in the school. All other activities were given less importance and only curricular activities were given a lot of importance. Also, time spent on co-curricular activities may be considered as a waste of time by some people or some teachers. However, we need to keep in mind that both co-curricular as well as curricular activities are essential for the holistic development of the students. Both curricular and co-curricular activities are complementary to each other and they deserve equal weight and emphasis while planning the total school program during a full session. Co-curricular activities need to be given equal importance while planning as the students can learn several skills and competencies from these activities in a real life situation and in a very joyful environment. Thus, we can say that activities which are not part of the academic curriculum but are acknowledged to be an essential part of the school life are called co-curricular activities. And they include many activities like sports, school bands, participating in student newspaper, etc. They may also be called extracurricular, that is activities carried on outside the regular course of study, activities outside the usual duties of a job as extra class activities according to the International Dictionary of Education. But we need to know, why do we need to plan the co-curricular activities for our students? There are many characteristics of co-curricular activities which directly or indirectly help the classroom teaching. Co-curricular activities supplement and complement the entire teaching learning process and effectively impact student learning outcomes. They also strengthen the classroom teaching and help to clear the concepts of certain topics which we are teaching as part of the curriculum activities. Extracurricular activities emphasize development of creativity, aesthetics, as well as spiritual development in our students. And these are very important components of overall education of a student. Extracurricular activities also help in developing features like speech fluency and language skills. They help students to express their ideas freely due to active participation in debates. Co-curricular activities are also a good platform to excel in acting, singing, speaking, and recitation. Discussions also are encouraged in these activities. And through these discussions, students are helped in generating ideas and inculcating various values. Games and sports make students mentally and physically fit and sound. Games make students learn how to perform while losing or winning in an event. Therefore, they are very important for the social and emotional development of the students. Sometimes, classroom teaching becomes monotonous and routine-bound. Conducting these co-curricular activities can enthuse a lot of excitement in our students. Therefore, co-curricular activities can bring pleasant and joyful experiences in the classroom and among our students. Thus, we can say that co-curricular activities have many advantages in the student's life. They help in realizing the all-round development of the student, and the curriculum is amalgamated with co-curricular activities or extracurricular activities. Co-curricular activities help in realization of aims and objectives of our education on a whole. And co-curricular activities therefore become an integral part of the school's curriculum and the student's life. Now let us discuss what are the different types of co-curricular activities in a school. If you look at physical development, there are various outdoor and indoor games and sports that a school or a classroom teacher can organize. There are various athletic events. The students can also be involved in various other activities like gardening. These activities facilitate normal growth and development of the body. They help in developing healthy habits, and they also help in developing physical fitness and health of the students. There are certain activities which promote the motor development of students. And these activities include clay modeling, basket making, toy making, knitting, and so on. And they facilitate the development of the small muscles and are very important for children. There are certain activities which help in the development of our language skills. These include debates, storytelling, essay writing, recitation, writing for the school magazine, for the newspaper, school newspaper, and so on. Now, these activities, when the student engages in these activities, it helps in the development of their language skills and speech. It helps in the development of their thought and expression. It develops their creativity and comprehension skills, and therefore are very important for all students. There are certain activities which cater to the aesthetic and cultural development amongst the students. These include activities like music, dance, folk singing, drawing, paintings, participating in fancy dress competitions, school decorations, flower festivals, exhibitions, and so on. These activities help in the understanding of the cultural heritage and the traditions of the community and of the country. They also help in familiarizing the students with the cultural elements and the ethos of the society they are part of. So they are very important for the development of cultural awareness and interests among students. Certain activities like celebration of festivals, national days, participating in mock parliament or court sessions, being part of student council, all these activities help in the in promoting civic development of the students. And they facilitate acquisition of rich experiences in one's life. They help in understanding the democratic process of functioning of the governments of the society. And therefore are very important and should be inculcated in the school curriculum. There are certain activities which help in the social development of the students. These include participating in morning assemblies, participating in programs which are organized by Red Cross Society, surveys, cleanliness campaigns, awareness campaigns, and so on. Now, these facilitate or develop the process of socialization in the students. They help in the art of social living. They help the students to understand the importance of sharing, of working in team and leadership qualities, and being loyal to groups. Therefore, these are very important and should be it should be included in the school curriculum. Then there are certain activities which help in the development of hobbies. These are recreational and leisure time activities like stamp collection, coin collection, collection of pictures and so on, photography, making of albums. They help the students in utilizing their time effectively. They help in promoting creativity amongst the students. Certain other activities can also be planned in the school activity. These include picnics, visit to the museum, the aquariums, trip to places of geographical and historical importance, of cultural interests, and they promote overall learning in the student. Therefore, we can say that planning of co-curricular activities is an important component of the school activities. But how do we plan this curriculum? And how do we plan the co-curricular activities and involve all the students? Following four important considerations are to be taken into account while planning the co-curricular activities in our school. Judicious selection of activities, provision of time and space for conducting the activities, provision of motivation, provision of advice and feedback. When we are talking about selection of activities, we need to keep in mind that organization of all types of co-curricular activities during a particular session in any school is not practically feasible because of the constraint of time, space, and resources. Hence, we need to make a judicious selection of activities. Activities should be reasonably large in number, and they should be varied in order to provide opportunities to all students to participate in several activities. The activities should be in accordance with students' interest and ability. The activities should not impose excess strain on students. While selecting activities, we also need to be careful that those activities should be selected which attract spontaneous participation of the students. It is also important to keep in mind that the activities should be economical, that the essential material can be easily brought by the students from home, or these materials are made available by the school within the limited resources of the school. Let us look at the how to provision for time and space for the co-curricular activities in our school. Depending upon the availability and suitability of time and space, activities are to be planned and organized in schools. Separate rooms in schools may also be allotted and used for conduct of various indoor activities. Some specific outdoors and indoor activities may require provision in the school timetable for their organization during regular school hours. But some other activities may require provision for their organization before or after the school hours. For example, we can organize morning games 1 hour before the school starts, or we can keep special classes related with robotics, clay modeling, paper mache after the school is over. It is important to see that some activities may be planned and organized in particular seasons and months. For example, picnics, outdoor activities should be planned in when the weather is good. When the weather is warm or extreme cold is there, then indoor activities may be planned. Activities related with patriotism, for example, can be planned around the Independence Day or Republic Days. All such activities are to be planned date-wise and month-wise for the whole session. And it is a good idea to inform the students and the parents beforehand about these activities. We can inform them through the annual planner or the diary that is given to the students. A reminder circular may be sent to the students and parents in the beginning of every month about all the activities that have been planned during that month. This will help prepare the students for those activities. As regards the space, such activities may be organized within the school premises, provided there is adequate space, adequate and suitable space is available. For example, we need to have open playgrounds for organizing sports and games activities. Performances of students can be organized if there are auditoriums. Allotting of special rooms can be done for classes related with photography, clay modeling, woodwork activities. Use of courtyards or the corners in the schools can also be made use of by partially covering them and making them into open auditoriums or open covered playgrounds. In the absence of availability of adequate and suitable space inside the school, the same may be conducted outside in the open space nearby the school. But safety of the children needs to be considered when we are taking the children outside our school. It is very important that the students are motivated to participate in all the activities. This can be done by displaying a long list of activities in the school information board for the knowledge of all students. So the students know what activities have been planned and they have a choice. They can then choose the activity they are interested in and apply for a specific activity or a activity class. Encouraging the students to take initiative for conduct of such activities by acting as advisor and facilitator is also very important. The function and mode of organization of each activity should be well spelled out to motivate the students. Each teacher in the school needs to remain in charge of any particular activity of his or her interest. This way, the teachers can motivate and provide adequate advice to the students how to go about the activities. You must have adequate experience and must demonstrate enthusiasm and positive attitude for organizing the concerned activities. Also, it is very important to take students' feedback and feedback of others in the school. This will help in modifying the activities and knowing which activity works and which activity was not very successful. Any activity, co-curricular activity, will be successful only when we ensure that there is adequate logistic support, that is, the required equipment or material in the school is available for the activity. There should be mutual understanding among the teachers while advising students on a particular issue or activity. Therefore, we need to keep certain things in mind when we are planning the co-curricular activities for our school. The teacher must be a good planner so that different activities can be planned and carried out systematically during the academic year. Some common activities can be planned for the entire school, like mass parades, drills, yoga sessions, singing, dance recitals, and so on. But some of the activities can be more specific to certain grades, depending on the age appropriateness of the activities. For example, planning art and craft, tearing and pasting activities for the younger children, planning paper mache for the older children, and so on. Opportunities for all students to participate in activities, depending on their interest and choice, is a very important aspect of planning any co-curricular activity in the school. We need to encourage innovation and creativity when the children are involved in these co-curricular activities. Also, it is very important to encourage students to be independent and to take responsibility of their co-curricular activities. The teacher needs to provide a detailed instruction written on info sheet which can be photocopied for each student. This should be available to all the students so that they have a clear picture of what activities they are going to do in that particular class or session. The teacher can also hold discussion on students' action plans. Students need to be clear on details related with the activity, whereas other material should be available in the classroom or the activity room, like blackboards, display boards, flip charts, flip books made available to the students. Other material also needs to be available in abundance, like pens, pencils, crayons, scissors, glue sticks, clay, etc. Therefore, we can summarize the session of planning the co-curricular activities as follows. The meaning of co-curricular activities revolves around its different features and characteristics. For the overall development of a child, curriculum is not only the single criteria. And the holistic growth and development of the child or the student depends on planning of various activities, the co-curricular activities. Co-curricular activities affect all domains of life, such as cognitive, emotional, social, moral, cultural, and aesthetics. Competitiveness, excellence, quality, achievements, creativeness, and enthusiasms are also some of the extra benefits of co-curricular activities. And they also help in strengthening the various other activities that are planned in the school. They also support students to venture into professional fields like fashion, music, painting, art, acting, photography, printing, and many more. That's why students need co-curricular activities, which helps in enhancing many skill development. Therefore, we all agree that planning of co-curricular activities has many advantages. The importance of co-curricular activities in school curriculum has been widely acknowledged by many countries in their respective curriculum framework. It has also been acknowledged in the National Curriculum Framework of India. So it is advised that the teachers and the school personnel plan a number of extracurricular and co-curricular activities for the overall development of the students in the school. So learners, we will meet you in our next session. Till then, thank you.